station for Bwipo. He's gonna lose his blue buff, he's gonna fall even further behind, and what he was doing to Willa is now happening to him.
Yeah, Willa backstage is rubbing his hands together gleefully right here.
Hang
Wei
on.
Though does have flash. Gonna get the Spectral Maul stun here onto Adam. No flashes on Bwipo. Adam, there's the flash away from Wei. Niski down towards the bottom side, just getting wailed away on by Crying. The flash forward as they look to Xiaohu. No flash on the cannon either. Wei's trying to get away. Bwipo needs the auto attack. Stun's gonna land onto Niski. That's first blood. Wei escapes. Adam and Bwipo now level one, running back to the safety of their tower. Crying locks in the gold card.
There are zero TPs available right now, and I think the bot dive is the play.
Min's gonna try and get out of here. Gets caught in the middle of his jump. Has to flash.
Oh, but Adam is now in trouble.
Adam not yet level 6, doesn't have the Ragnarok, turned up with the Slicing Mash from Wei on his way as well. Adam trying to get out of this, the undertow. He's going to go back and pick it up. Now takes the flash away. Spectral Maw, stun. Wei goes wide. Adam still running for the hills here. Destiny's coming in. A counter Destiny as well. And now Niski's in for a world of hurt. Underneath the tower, Xiaohu goes. And Niski, Destiny straight to his demise.
But such a match. He was level 6, and he ends up punishing Adam in the 1 versus 1. He's now going to secure himself more plates. Now, let's see if Fnatic can get something back on the cross map.
Ming actually going for the engage here. Still going to get stunned up. Hillisang Glow Ignite is taking. Gala dives forward, and Ming takes the kill. Bwipo here a little bit too late. Dragon's Rage kick available, but he misses the Sonic Wave. Now the TP's come in, and Fnatic are trying to make plays on the map. Bwipo will be able to take out one, but Xiaohu comes in charge of Crystal Arrow from Bean. There's the kick. Gala down. Bean survives. Xiaohu down as well. And Bean, the substitute, gets 3 kills in the early game. What was...
Bean flashes away. We don't have time because we've got more fire.
Hillisang has 6 here. Death from Below is going to land it. Crying going in with the Destiny as well. Death from Below from Hillisang just to try and get away from this Spectral Maw. Flash. Bean stunned up. Wei takes out Hillisang and now underneath the tower. That's the shutdown. RNG answer back in the bottom lane. However, Niski's on his way. Bwipo there as well. Dragon's Rage kick about to come off cooldown. There's the stun card. Bwipo once again missing the Sonic Waves. Call of the Q not quite hitting yet. Gala dives away.
Relatively safe as Hillisang looking for any opportunity to find a pick. Wei, once again, up towards the top side of the map. This man is always proactive.
Know that Bwipo's here. Xiaohu doesn't have flash, doesn't have a way to get across here. Sonic Wave once again going wide, but Bwipo's on his way. There's the Destiny. Bwipo underneath the tower, stun carded up. Spectral Maw just short once again. TP's coming in as Niski tries to join this. And once again, it feels like Fnatic are throwing good after bad here. With the TP coming in from Niski, not really much he could do.
This team, whenever there is action about to happen, and this is how he utilizes the Swiss Fate so well. Now this is a 2 versus 3.
Magnestorm coming out, this TP as well. Stopwatch from Crying keeps him alive. And Charter Crystal is going to hit onto Xiaohu in the TP. Immediately, Adam just runs in the wrong direction. This is something that has plagued
Fnatic roster. They're trying to force plays, and here comes another one.
Looking for Crying underneath the tower. Burn Skewer is going to land. Crying, no flash, no way out. Shut down, goes over to Niski.
So, this time round, Fnatic are able to make a play successful. They're able to shut down Crying and get a little bit of gold into that lane. He was very far behind in lane, and he was struggling, but because he's been given so much freedom and the tower, he's now completed his first item. He's ahead of farm versus Bean. And, hang on.
Everfrost coming out, Ming caught in it. Wasn't intended for him. Here's Hillisang as well. There's the Bone Skewer, the Crying who has to flash away. Magnestorm pop now. And after a moment of self-control, Fnatic lose all of it once again. Gala takes the kill onto Niski. Xiaohu chasing Hillisang down off towards the top side. Misses with the initial shuriken, so Hillisang should be able to go away, but Xiaohu not having any of that. Flashes in for the kill.
That could be bad for Xiaohu. Yeah, okay, Bwipo going to come in and save him there. But Wei is going to do a lot of single target damage, look to try and get resets. Oh my, Hillisang plays on the edge.
I mean, it's just the tech stuff. He gets the kill of Instinct down, I guess. And Gala's flash in. There's the Destiny. And the chase is on once again. Crying. Looking for it, but couldn't quite find the gold card. Tower falls in the top side, and RNG just continually accepting it. RNG constantly showing us why a lot of people look at them as strong favorites for the tournament. We're going for the kickback. Crying here, we're locking the gold card. Niski on his way as well, and Crying doesn't really have a way to get away from this one. No flash for him, means that he will fall. Fnatic able to dodge across the wall with. Right now, RNG are the ones pushing forward. Xiaohu has the attract repel on him, and Niski is backing in a bush. He was in the shop, and the stopwatch will only stop time for a second. Niski dies. Xiaohu now on a killing spree. And Bwipo doing basically the exact same thing his mid laner did, except without the death there. As RNG gain control of the bottom side river. And with 20 seconds on the Cloud Drake, they should be able to secure that pretty soon.
A lot of mistakes from Niski this game. We've seen him overcommit, overforce, and now losing to the shopkeeper, literally, as another fight kicks off.
There's the magnet sword from Ming onto the back line. Hinnerseng trying to get away, and Charter Crystal Arrow goes through the uprights, and there comes the slicing mass from great kick back by Whipper, but the rocket belt is back up. Hinnerseng tries to get away, will just about escape Destiny from crying on towards the back. Fiend's gonna open up, try and get the damage down with the Ash, but already RNG get another couple of kills, and they work their way straight across. Fiend coming in from crying as RNG. 4,000 HP on the Baron, being stepping forward. Adam there as well. There's no smite here for Fnatic, but they still won the fight. Wade secures it. Adam down already. Nitsuki down as well. And I can do nothing but laugh because it's so Fnatic to see. 18 kills to 6 now. RNG, Baron buff.
RNG have just responded so much better. Fnatic, they are not slowing down.
Maybe they should. As Whippo looks for the fight. Here comes Xiaohu! And immediately he's turned back around on RNG. Hillersang trying to put the damage down as he can. Can't quite get the stun, but there's the death from below, and maybe they shouldn't. Wei now in a 2v1 as Whippo continues to trade in. Ming on his way, a track propel will land the stun. Doesn't want to use it yet. Dragon's Rage kick will knock Wei back. Hillersang still looking for it. Death from below isn't enough damage. The counter, the Heartbreaker from Wei goes wide, and the fight continues as Hillersang in the end falls to Ming. They're gonna chase Whipple as well because Wei has stolen away the Phantom Undertow, but Nitsuki dives back in. The slicing maelstrom to turn it back around. Garlo already unstoppable, and Wei still survives. Nitsuki down, Wei in the end will fall. Adam trying to chase onto Garlo, he'll get the shutdown there. Ming with the crash down, being low. Adam now in a 2v1, the exhaust will tick away on him, but he will still be able to get a triple kill.
Hang on.
He's healing up the Undertow crying. Do you have a gold card to lock in? Find one in your stack deck. He'll be
ready.
Here we go. TP coming in. Bone Skewer goes wide. Everfrost going to hit Adam. Doesn't have the flash. Looking for the Undertow. Connects with the edge of it. And Hillersang can... Oh, he messes it up. He messes up the dive across the wall, but crying still caught out. And crying will fall.
No Baron left. That's it. All the Barons are gone. It's a point of contention. The truth is the RNG is just so far ahead in itemization.
Ming going in with the Magnus Storm, Wei is here, Crying's coming in with the Destiny as well, but Ming's already dead. Death from below is going to find that mark. They're looking to try and chase into Garla. The Slicing Master wants at the back line, is able to get enough. Whipple able to kill off Garla, pop the stopwatch, two of you, as now it's a 3v3. Nitsuki will fall, Adam and Whipple are the only two left alive for Fnatic. The chase continues. Crying, no flash, Whipple able to safeguard across the wall. Adam, no Ragnarok, and Xiaohu can chase him down, but with the Undertow, there's the slow. Wei will get the movement speed from the Harrowed Path. Adam cannot get away from the Spectral Maw, and that is enough. Adam tries to kill off Xiaohu, but doesn't have the damage to do it.
And this is exactly it.
Pushing out the bottom lane. There is a TP ward behind them. Wei here. Oh, he's on the right side here of Whippo, who is looking for something, but now he's on the wrong side of dodge. Bone Skewer's gonna land. Whippo gonna dive. Waiting arm straight into Garlo, who will take the kill. Crying, looking for a little bit more out of this one. There's the killer instinct from Garlo, and immediately he dives onto the back line, and Bean is down. It's a triple for Garlo as he wipes away the bottom side of Fnatic's map.
And RNG once again punish.
To pass where the inhibitor usually would be. Hillersang lands another hook, but Ming really doesn't mind too much. Crying has the destiny to join his team if a fight erupts in the middle lane. The inhibitor not taking too... inhibitor's tower not taking too much damage as Kai'Sa, not the longest range AD carry in the world, will struggle to walk up there in the face of Hillersang. The wave still about 5 seconds away, so Fnatic actually had time to clear that bot wave and then catch this mid wave. Question is, will Garla push forward? Arrow is only going to land onto Xiaohu. There's the Everfrost as well. Ming chunked out a little bit. Apple Fire Cannon from Crying, putting some damage down onto the tower. And here goes Xiaohu with a Slicing Maelstrom into the Magnus Storm. And Fnatic, a valiant defender. Their base was ended in a heartbeat by RNG. Bean down. RNG with a triple kill for Xiaohu. Death below finds nothing. And RNG will clean ace Fnatic in their base.
Excellent dive from RNG. They'd had enough of the wave clear from Fnatic. They knew they had the gold lead. They know they have the items. And they know that they have the damage to wipe Fnatic off the map.
RNG undefeated in their group.